Hello everyone, this is Justin from Justin's Orchids and More. It is April 3rd, Sunday. Beautiful Sunday here in South Carolina. I finally finished my work week. Enjoying my day off. I'm in the greenhouse today, and I had to go to Lowe's and get some Orchiana bark because I'm going to be doing another repot today on my Fred Clark After Dark using that PET method. I'll take a look at the witchcraft, show you guys how it looks after being in the PET method for a week. And then I got a couple more catasetums that I got to do. Don't necessarily know if I'm going to do the PET method with all of them. I really had luck last year just in Orchiana bark. You know what I mean? Like, so I don't know yet. We'll see. But when I came back home, I noticed there was a box on the porch, and, I'm pretty sure this is a orchid that I ordered last week, off of eBay. And, here's the thing about this, guys. Now, I know you guys out there, if you buy orchids off of eBay, there's a certain seller out there, and a lot of growers, you know him as the infamous white chair guy. A lot of times he'll take pictures of the orchid he's selling, and he has it hanging up on this plastic, you know, chair that would go outside that you get from Walmart, you know, just a plastic chair that goes on your porch. And we call him the white chair guy, okay? The thing about him is he sells really bad orchids sometimes. They're not healthy. Oftentimes, they're diseased, have scale pests. I had one that had scale so bad, I had to throw it away. Couldn't get rid of scale. I just had to throw the whole plant away, okay? So if you're ever on eBay and you see an orchid in a white chair, run away from it, okay? just keep going. Get away from it. Don't even buy nothing from him. But here's the thing about him, though, okay? Here's the thing. And I was talking to Paula about this. Honestly, the dude's got a lot of just rare orchids. He's got orchids that nobody else has. That's the thing, okay? And that's why I keep looking on his page. Anyway, okay, so I don't know. I paid a little bit too much for this plant, but I wanted it. And here's the thing. I had it saved for about 3 weeks, and I kept looking at it. And when I went to buy it, you know, it wasn't a picture. This orchid wasn't sitting in a white chair. This orchid just showed a picture of the blooms and showed it a picture hanging up. You know what I mean? Just like hanging somewhere in the basket, I think it was in. So the white chair guy tricked me, okay? Because I didn't look at the seller when I bought it. And after I bought the plant, I was like, I wonder where this plant's actually coming from. Because I want to know how long it would take to get there. Well, sure enough, I seen his name. And I'm not going to say his name on here, but the white chair guy got me. He tricked me. Oh, Lord. Anyway, I don't know that this plant's going to look good. We're going to really inspect this plant when I open it. Definitely going to take a look at it. But, yeah, that's the little story for today. I hope everybody's doing really good. I've been wanting to make a video. I hadn't made one in a while. And just really having a good day today. I am. I was looking at the weather. I don't know why he just didn't leave it in the box without having to wrap the paper around it. Anyway, it's taped on really good as far as packaging goes so far. But make sure I'm in camera. I want to take all my plants that I want to put outside out from the house and from in here. I want to take them to start bringing them outside today, but I was looking at the weather, and next week we do have about 3 nights that are going to be not in the low 40s, but lowish 40s. So I'm going to wait one more week, and I think next Sunday is when I'm going to take all of my plants and put them outside, the ones that are going to be going outside. There's actually going to be some orchids going out there in full sun, too. I've got a few that I like to get full sun to. So, all right. But, yeah, I'm going to be doing another video on my Fred Clark After Dark today, and I'll probably post that later on, too. I don't know what else. Hold on a minute. My address is on. He's put my address on here twice. No, he hasn't. Never mind. That's his address. Out of respect. There you go, bud. Okay. Yeah. I've been kind of getting into Vanda species. especially the mid-sized to smaller ones. Mid-sized to, you know, not so much the really large ones, but I really like the Vanda species. It's something I'm trying to get into. I've got a few in my collection. Here's another one, I think. Okay, peanuts. Not need this today. I don't want this crap to spill everywhere. Hold on 1 second. Okay, yeah, I'm just not dealing with that mess today in here. Let me move this box out of the way. Yes. Okay, so this is supposed to be a Vanda species, and let me be careful here. Let's do this. Let's see. Like that. This is supposed to be Vanda Morellii. I'll put the name up and a picture. I just really, like I said, I'm really getting into some, trying to get some Vanda species. And here we go. Wow. I really paid too much for that plant. I thought it was a lot bigger. But let's take a look at it. Okay, so let's double check the name. Yes. Vanda Morellii. Let me get this bent up here out of the way. It's in a 4-inch basket. No, 3-inch basket. Plant's a little bit smaller than I thought it would be, but I'm looking at it. I'm looking at the roots. I don't see any scale. The plant doesn't look diseased. It needs some nitrogen. That's really what it needs. It needs to green up a little bit. But overall, the plant looks okay. Like I said, it's a little bit smaller, but that's okay. You know, what I'll do is I'll put some Spanish moss right in here, like I do my other Vandas. Put some in the basket right here. Hang it up, let it go. This will probably grow well for me. I'm happy with it. I'm okay with this. So thank you, white chair guy. Appreciate it. All right, guys, let me go because I want to start doing this Fred Clark After Dark. I'll make that video and put it out later on. See you guys on the next one.